Hi, Alex here from redeveloper.com and welcome back to the channel. Today we are going to build out a SwiftUI application with iCloud. So if you want to build out this app, go ahead and keep on watching. Furthermore, hit the subscribe button. So let's just jump right into it. So let's take a look at the project that I have created for this awesome iCloud with SwiftUI tutorial. Now go ahead and click the link down below to take a look at this project, and this is a starter project, and let me just guide you through real quick so we can get into the meat and balls. Okay, let's go into our scene delegate, and here we have a list of items, and that is basically set as the environment object. Now if you don't know what environment object is, go ahead and take a look at my previous video, and you will also find out a lot more about states there. So this list elements is basically a observable object, and it has a published variable of items. Now this holds the list of items. That is what we will have, a list of items that we will save onto iCloud. Now let's go to our list element. Now this list element, of course, you need to have it as identifiable because we are putting it into a SwiftUI list, and it has an ID, of course, as a UUID. This is needed for the identifiable protocol, and it has a text. Now it also has a record ID, and that is optional, and this is needed for CloudKit. We will see that in just a moment. Okay, finally, let's take a look at our content view, and here we have our environment object, list of elements, and some private state variables, the new item, show edit text field, edited item, and this will be used in order to save, modify, delete, and fetch from CloudKit, iCloud. Okay. Now, let's see what we have here. First of all, let's just build and run, and it's real easy to say that. So we have a navigation view with a navigation by SwiftUI with CloudKit. We have a text field here and the button add. This is where we will add our new elements. And then we have this double tap to edit, long press to delete. Well, here I'm just saying what you can do, and these will be on this list. I don't know if this is clear. We have these lines, we have this list here. So that is what this view is all about. So here we have our text field, our add button, then we have our text field that will be shown to edit the item. Then we have the double tap to edit, long press to delete text. And finally, we have our list that has an on tap gesture and an on long press gesture recognizer. Okay, and then we have some animations and a navigation bar title. Finally, we have an on appear, and that is where CloudKit Helper will fetch our items basically. Now, this CloudKit Helper, let's just jump right into there. These are just functions that complete with an error or some other type of success, and basically that's it. This is where we will do the most of the work, and let's just go back and show you where these are used. So if you go, you can see here saving to iCloud. Let's just take a look at that. So we are saving the new item that is from the list, and we are getting back a result. If the result is successful, then we add that new item to the list elements items. So we are inserting it at index 0. Otherwise, we are just going to print out the errors localized description. So that is what we are going to do today in this video. Otherwise, we will also modify, delete, and fetch from CloudKit. That's for the next episode of this series. So what do we have to do first? Well, first of all, I already have this enabled, but you have to do the enabling on under signing and capabilities. And if you go and tap on this plus button that says plus capability. Let me just show you. Just search for iCloud. Mine doesn't say search it because we already have it added here. And make sure that you have enabled CloudKit and this iCloud dot and your bundle identifier. Now, there may be a lot more, but make sure you are choosing this one, okay? And of course, you have to have a theme and automatically manage signing. So that's it. Now, let's go to the CloudKit dashboard, and that is pretty easy. Just go ahead and click on CloudKit dashboard, and you will be taken. Maybe you will need to sign in. Let's enter our passcode here. So there we go. Let's just search for our, let's say, Swift UI. There we go. Let's select this container. And here you will see all of your data, your schema, and so on. Now, let's go back to Xcode, because we are going to, let's see Xcode, we are going to add some code here. Let's go to our CloudKit helper, and as you can see, all of this is nicely set up, so we have a separation of concerns. We are dealing with CloudKit logic here. So first thing we need to create here is a struct, and that is a record type. So struct record type, and that record type will be a static let items. So static let items. Now we will use this record type to create a CKS CloudKit record. So today we are going to focus on this function, that is save item with the completion. Now we add a list element, and for the completion we might get back that list element, of course, and we might get back an error. So we are handling that inside our content view. Okay, so first thing first, let's create our item record. So let item record equals, and this will be a CK record. And record type, and that is what we have created here, a record type dot items. Okay, pretty straightforward. Now, why do we need this item record? Well, because we want to add some elements onto this item record. So item record, let's see, text, because that is what we are going to add. We are going to add a text here, and that will be equals to the item, that is the list element, dot text. And we want to save this as a CK record value. So CK record value. Okay, so now that we have our item record, now it's time to save it. And that is pretty simple. But first of all, you need to know about the public database, the private database, and the shared database. We are going to save and fetch from and to the public database. Basically, that is on your account, and it can be accessed throughout the whole app's users. Now, for the public, of course, that will be on the user's iCloud account, and it will be on their database, and that will be accessed only through that user. Now with the shared, you can share some, but we won't go through that. We are just going to save now on the public database. So let's start off with CK container dot default. And let's add in here our public database. There we go. And let's have our save operation, and we are going to use the one with the record. So save record, and we already have our item record here. There we go, it is a CK record, and we have a completion handler, which has a CK record and an error returning. Now, both of these are optional, so we need to guard that, unwrap those. So let's see, record and error. Okay, first of all, I will if let unwrap our error equals error, then we want to complete with an error. So that is pretty simple. So completion dot failure, and we are using a Swift file result, so that is why we can use this failure, and the failure's error will be error. So let's return just to be sure, and then we want to guard let unwrap our record. So guard let record equals record else. So if there isn't a record, we want to again complete completion.failure, and this time we want to use these already created Cloud Kit Helper errors. So Cloud Kit Helper error dot and record failure. Record failure, that is what it is. So now you know why we needed this enum of our Cloud Kit Helper errors. And we want to return. Now that we do have our record, now we can construct our list element that will be completed as a success. So let's see. First of all, let's take care of our record ID. So let ID equals, and I will just call upon this record dot and ID, record ID it is. So we do have our ID. Now it's time for the text. And we need to guard let unwrap our text equals record. And let's see, the key will be text. And we need to cast this as a string. Otherwise, we want to complete completion.failure. And the error, again, will be an error that we have created, cast failure. And that is CloudKit error and record failure, cast failure, sorry. There we go. And we want to return. Okay, now it's time to create our item. So let item or element or whatever, let's call it element, equals, so this will be a list element. And as you can see, we have two options, and we will use the one with the ID, record ID, and text. So we can omit the UID because that is already added by default, and the record ID will be this ID that we have created and our text. And finally, we can complete completion.success and element. There we go. And that should be it. Let's hit Command B and see if all of this is okay. Oh, we need an else here. And there we go. Hit Command B. And everything should be okay. Build has succeeded. Great. So before we test this out, let's go to our iCloud dashboard and select your development and your schema. If you're on data, just choose schema. There we go. And you should see a custom text field. If not, then go ahead and create one, like add text field, and make sure that you have queryable, searchable, and sortable. So make sure the text custom field is a string and all of these indexes are added there. You can also edit the indexes if you wanted to. Okay, you can add an index and so on. So once that is out of the way, let's just go back to our Xcode project and build and run. And hopefully we will be able to add some new data. Of course, it will not populate the list, but nonetheless, we will have it on the iCloud dashboard. So let's add in here Alex. Let's just click on add. And yeah, it says, and this is really important, it says error saving record. And this is quite confusing. Create operation not permitted. Why? We did allow it. So what you need to do is just go into your simulator, or rather yet, your simulator or your device, if you are checking this on a real device, and go to settings. So you need to be logged in with the with this iCloud account. Go to settings. Let's sign in. Okay, now that we are signed in, let's go back and try to save that into our CloudKit dashboard. So let's type in Alex maybe. Let's click on add. And it says successfully added item. Hooray! And of course it did update the list because, and let me just show you why, under the content view, once we do get back a success for our result, so save item new value, we get back this new value and we insert that into our list elements items array. So it says that this is going to be on the background thread, so it is not allowed. So let's create our save CloudKit helper on the main thread. So let's go back to the CloudKit helper and right here let's go and type in dispatch queue, there we go, dot main dot async, and here we have our code. Let's copy that out and that should fix it. There we go, and build and run again, and hopefully we will not have anything under the content view. Let's see, let's add, of course we are not fetching, and that's why we are not having that Alex populated here. But let's see, developer, and let's add that in there. Okay, successfully added item. Okay, and it has been updated, and now let's check under the content view. Yay, no background thread needed. Now let's take a look at our data. And let's see, public database, checked, zone, default zone, items, yeah, filters, none, and let's query our records. And as you can see, I have a few of them already here, and here we have our developer, our Alex, and I believe I did have this saved 2 days ago, as you can see. So yeah, that is already in the database. Now in the next video, we are going to fetch, delete, and modify, so really, really interesting stuff coming up. I hope you enjoyed this video where we managed to save some data into iCloud with the help of SwiftUI. How awesome is that? So I want you to hit that notification bell and subscribe to the channel, because in my next video, I am going to not only save some data to CloudKit, we are going to fetch, delete, and modify some data with the help, of course, of SwiftUI. While you wait for that, go ahead and check out these two videos too. I talk a lot about SwiftUI, app development, and iOS development in general. So make sure to check out these videos too. And as always, I will see you in the next one.